Good evening, dear friends, dear parents, and everyone listening to us. Today we are here back again with a very interesting topic, importance of storytelling to kids. And on this dais today we have a special guest, Mrs. Darshana Mehta, who is a mother of two children. She has been a teacher in a school and she believes that in her upbringing, storytelling has played a vital role. Darshana?
Yes, I have always grown up on my grandmother's stories and I have always been a good storyteller to both my kids. Now they are quite big, one is 16-year-old, one is 12-year-old. I also used to be an avid watcher of serials on TV. Of the 1980s, there was one serial, Dada Dadi Ki Kahaniya. It had a lovely jingle to it, Dada Dadi Ki Kahaniya, Sadiyo Yaad Rahe.
Dada Dadi Ki Kahani. Very, very true. Even I used to watch that serial. Very much.
So, be it the wit of Birbal or the righteousness of the Pandavas, Bikram and Baital, so many stories we've grown up on, all these have input to what we are as grown ups today.
Exactly. And India actually, you know, is a treasure of these stories. We don't have to look anywhere else. We have a treasure of these stories in our own country. Anything like Amar Chitra Kathai, Panchtantra, Tinkle, yes, these are all the books, you know, where stories are
it's
there.
It's a culture, culture, it's a heritage.
Very true. Do you find, Darshana, that storytelling plays an integral part in the overall development of a child?
Yes, definitely. Storytelling introduces new vocabulary to children. Then it also enhances and encourages the child to visualize and imagine. So that skill is also developed in the child. Plus the child becomes a good listener. Usually children are less of listeners.
These things, you know, the communication between the mother and the child enhances the listening skill, which is very important now.
When the child is in the infancy stage, it absorbs most words which it uses in its later life. So storytelling should be a part of a parent's schedule from the very beginning.
Very beginning.
And when the children grow up, then they start to relate to what they have learned in the infancy. And thus, the development continues of the visualization, the imagination, creativity. That development continues even further.
Very true. In visualization, I would like to go a little deeper. Like, I would like to explain that whenever a story is narrated to a child, you know what happens? Supposing you are telling a story of Cinderella and you started narrating the story, there's a palace. The child actually makes those images in his mind.
Creativity.
Exactly. Yeah, the creativity. And what happens, you know, if one story is repeatedly told to the child, the child goes in deeper. Like first he just sees the walls, then he sees the windows, then he sees the doors.
The color.
Exactly. And he tries to input, tries to add everything of his own. So, you know, the visual effect also develops in the child's mind. Plus, the imagination level of the child increases through storytelling because there are no barriers in storytelling, you know. Anything can happen, as I say, horses can fly, fishes can walk, everything can happen in storytelling.
And if a mother, like for a child, to develop some manners, some habits, in other ways she can always put with a story and tell the child, so the child will absorb it more better and will also like to listen it.
Very true. Like exactly same I do with my daughter who is 3-year-old. You know, whenever I want to inculcate certain habits into her, for example, not to push to anyone or to wait for her turn or to share, I always, you know, try to make a story wherein I address to her that these things this child is doing, are we supposed to do? You know, and that things are easily absorbed because she doesn't find me lecturing to her. She finds it an interesting story and then she relates to the character and then she feels that yeah, this thing I have to do, this thing I don't.
And it also puts the sequencing kind of thing in the child's mind, where the child keeps on thinking, iske baad kya hoga, iske baad aisa hoga.
The curiosity level is also developed.
And the thinking of the mind also goes, that gives a quite thinking process to a child. Importance of narrated a story to a child. First of all, it gives you some moments together. After a whole hectic day.
Actually, these days parents really don't have time to spend with
you. So, making a point with your child sitting and narrating a story would have many, many positive impacts on the child. Nowadays, we lack in children is the listening skill. When you have this narration of the story, the child will automatically have that listening skill and he will relate everything in his mind. If you want to tell anything your experience, any positivity you want to give to them, you can directly make your own stories and narrate to the child.
Exactly. And Darshana, another thing is, these days when I talk to parents, they always tell, ma'am, hum log to unko net pe dikha dete hain stories. Do you find the difference of narrating a story and the story via net?
Yes, yes. Stories on laptop versus storytelling by elders. Definitely a very hot topic for conversation. Actually, it is easier to put on a story on the net and show your child. But storytelling is an interactive activity. It is a human activity. What happens is, when you put on a story on the laptop, your brain, the person seeing the story, that person's brain becomes a dumping ground. Because you are not allowed to imagine, you are not allowed to think, visualize the story. Somebody puts a picture in front of you, an image in front of you, of whatever they think is appropriate.
And that is a limit.
And that is a limit.
You see that and you think that much.
Also, it is a very fast-paced visual media. So, you are not allowed time to stress on what you like to know more.
Exactly. It means any character, any situation, any incident you want to relate, you don't have time.
Yes, you don't have time.
So, like when I am, for example, as a mother, if I am narrating a story and if my child wants to pause and ask me two questions, in the net or in the technology, it is not allowed. So, you have to go according to the pace, as you say.
So, if the mother is telling the story, she can put up her accent, her dialogues, the way the character is, then the child will enjoy it more in a better way, the
right.
Mother doing the same.
This same function is enabled when you have to inculcate positive values to your child.
Right.
The
moral
media,
values
yes,
to the child.
The media is not going to do that.
Exactly.
If you want to stress on a particular positive value for your child, you can do it through storytelling.
Through storytelling, very true. And storytelling is not does not have any bar for age. As you said, from infancy to, I have a son of 19-year-old. Even to him, if I want to inculcate any of the quality of his age, I think story is the best medium to do that.
That is.
You know, so I think is storytelling these days, like parents staying in nuclear families, they don't have time. It is eroding somewhere. I feel that that touch of our ancient culture is somewhere missing these days. So from this medium, we really want to request the parents that if you look on to storytelling, it's the best medium, as you said, for vocabulary development. Because if you want to, you know, enhance their dictionary of words, storytelling is the best way.
Also your mother tongue.
Also your mother tongue, yes.
Because nowadays children are going, most of them are going to English medium schools. And therefore they are not aware of their mother tongue.
And they don't even need to, they don't know to read
their mother tongue. Exactly. And another thing, like vocabulary development is done, imaginary development is done. Your creativity, you are allowed, as you said, like if you are seeing a story on a net and otherwise your mother is narrating a story, you have a wide range of creativity to do whatever you want to.
And the child will also listen to you properly.
Exactly. And he has a gap of thinking also. Like repeatedly if you tell a story, for example, of the hare and the tortoise or thirsty crow, if 3-4 times you've told the story and then you allow your child, you will find definitely 6-7 new aspects which he will give you.
Add to it also.
Exactly.
According to his imagination.
Like in summer camps, what happens, Darshana, when we are playing with children, suppose 10-12 children are sitting in a circle and then I start. There was a big jungle, I stop and then pass a turn. Then he has to add on one sentence, another child will add on. And at the end, the story is so beautiful that you can't imagine. I mean, these are just imaginations. So I think parents can play these kind of, it's not always telling a story, you can play these kind of games also.
And question them so that we can also know how the child is thinking.
Exactly. Like whenever you are narrating a story, as Darshana said, that you can, you know, pressurize that point that ye mujhe ko inculcate karna hai, toh is cheez pe main stress karun. So you can also see the reaction of your child. Okay, how does he react? Like for example, if I want to teach my daughter about pushing, whenever I stress that word, I come to know how she reacts. And then next time when again I'm using the story, I can plus minus those things in that, you know. So that's the best medium to, you know, inculcate good values in children.
Yes, yes, all positive values. Like for example, honesty, loyalty, courage, valor, good, bad. And the most important one is of commitment.
Commitment.
Nowadays that is draining from society so fast. But when you are telling your child a story, you are committing your time, your patience, your love for that story from beginning to end, answering questions and queries. And after the act is complete, the satisfaction that the child gets from a complete story, you cannot compare it to any story, anything put on media or internet or mobile, stories have been a part of our childhood and also a part of what we are today as grown-ups. So it is a very important part of parenting, of childhood and of upbringing overall,
absolutely,
of society as a whole.
So I think storytelling, if you are doing, it's well and good, but if you are not doing, I think from today you should put into practice storytelling, and you will find tremendous benefits which will be helpful in your positive parenting also. With this, we wrap up today's video. Any message from your side, Darshna, to our listeners?
Happy talking and listening.
Thank you. Pooja, from your side?
Stories can create wonders in a child's life. So, at least put in habit of daily attempts. 10 minutes of bedtime stories will do wonders.
Exactly. With this, we wrap up our today's video. And from this medium, we request all the parents that storytelling really plays an integral part in the overall development of a child. So, please put storytelling into practice. Thank you.
Thank you.